Welcome back to the Wood Shop. Today we're talking about tools and material safety. So we're going to talk a little bit about compressed air, talk a little bit about tools, and how to keep yourself safe while you're working in the shop. Let's get started. So OH&S states that if we're working with compressed air, pneumatic tools or anything like that, we shouldn't use compressed air to blow the dust off of our clothing. If we do, the safe compressed air PSI to dust our clothes off with is only 10 PSI. The reason for that being is, if I'm dusting my clothes off, I risk getting air bubbles under my skin and also blowing dust all over the shop that others are breathing in. In addition, that flying debris could get under somebody's safety glasses and in their eyes. So oftentimes our tools will get dull or broken or out of adjustment. The two things we can do here are ask the teacher to fix them ourselves, or if we're not sure, just have the teacher fix them. What we don't want to do is leave those dull, broken, or out of adjustment tools in service. Otherwise, it's just a hassle for the next person, or it could possibly cause injuries. Back injuries are very common in shops, usually a result of lifting large or heavy objects. So if you're going to do so, get some help from somebody. Also, making sure that those large, heavy objects are stored properly so that they're not going to fall on somebody. Most accidents in the shop involve students' hands. So when working with sharp tools, I always want to keep my hands behind the working edge so that if the tool slips, it won't go into my hand or arm. We don't want to use our fingers to test for the sharpness of the tool. And we want to place our hand near but not on an object if it's a hot object and we're testing it for heat. To make sure our workpiece is properly secured so that it doesn't slip while we're either chiseling it or cutting it with a saw, we want to clamp it into a vise, or we could use a bench hook. Hold our piece up against the bench hook, or we can clamp our work piece directly to the table with a clamp, or we can use a hold fast. Goes into one of our bench dog holes, little hammer on top, and that workpiece isn't going anywhere. If you're not sure how to properly use or safely store a material, you can ask the teacher or refer to the MSDS binder. Also, don't carry sharp tools in your pocket or your mouth. Sounds silly, but some contractors like to put nails or screws in their mouth. Say you're climbing a ladder and you have your workpiece in one hand and your hammer in the other. Well, the nails go in your mouth. Well, if you were to fall off that ladder, or maybe even just sneeze, those things might end up in your gut. Finally, use the right tool for the job. Never pry with a chisel or hammer with a wrench using a file without a handle on the end of it. These tools are made for one certain purpose usually, and using them improperly will usually lead to broken or damaged tools. So take the time to get the right tool for the right job. Now, if you do break something or damage something in the shop, we usually won't charge you for it. Things happen, accidents happen. Let us know. The best thing to do is let the teacher know so that the tool can be removed from service and fixed or replaced. So complete the study guide, finish the quiz on D2L, stay safe, and God bless.